In this video, I'm going to show you how to change the color of anything in Photoshop. Hi, welcome back to the Photoshop Training Channel. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you four different examples on how to change the color or replace the color of anything in Photoshop. We're going to start with a basic example, but then we're going to move on to advanced techniques that will help you in those difficult projects. At the very end, I have a really cool blend diff trick that I think you're going to enjoy. It allows you to convert a blend diff transparency into a layer mask. Okay, let's get started. We're going to work with this document that contains a single layer. Now, before we do anything else, I want to show you two things really quick. I just want to get them out of the way. Number one is a couple of terms that I want you to understand. I don't know if you know them or not, but I want to make sure that we're all on the same page. So I'm going to double click on the foreground color picker. And I'm going to talk about hue, saturation, and brightness. And really, that's what this video is all about, changing the hue, saturation, and brightness of colors to make them into different colors. So what is hue? Hue is this slider here that basically allows you to select a color. It's measured in degrees from 0 to 360. Once it gets to 360, it goes back to 0, meaning it's red again. So that's hue. And you can click on that input box and use the up and down arrow keys to change it. Hold shift and the up and down arrow keys, and it increases in increments of 10. Then we have saturation. So let me select the color here. Saturation, notice that it's at 100, but if I use the down arrow key, you'll notice that the saturation decreases and that circle moves over to the left. So this is a visual representation of what saturation is. Then we have brightness, and I think that's the easiest one to understand. If we go up, the color becomes brighter. If we go down, the color becomes darker. So I think that's pretty easy to understand. So I just want to make sure that we all understand what I mean by hue, saturation, and brightness. Okay, I'm going to cancel this, and I'm going to talk about one other thing. Nested under the brush tool, you'll find the color replacement tool. Now, this is a tool that I don't necessarily use too often, but I'm pretty sure that somebody will ask about it in the comments. So I'm sort of answering that question now before it comes up. And the color replacement tool allows you to select a foreground color. So we'll select blue and then paint over the area that we want to replace. And it actually does a really good job. Notice that I'm not being very precise. Photoshop is finding the edges for me as it's replacing that red color with this blue color. The problem with this tool is that you're working destructively, which means that you're destroying the original pixels. Also, it doesn't give you a lot of control to adjust this tool. As you can see, you just paint over the original pixels and that's it. So that's the reason why I don't like the color replacement tool, but feel free to use it if it works for your needs. What I'm going to do in this tutorial is show you examples that are more flexible and that should work for a lot of different situations. So we're going to start with the basic example first. And the first thing that you should do is click on the quick selection tool, make a selection around the object whose color you want to change. In this case, this red shirt. And I don't have to be very precise because I'm going to be working with adjustment layers, and you can always come back and edit them if you need to. So with this selection active, I'm simply going to go into the new adjustment layer icon and select hue and saturation. This is going to create a hue and saturation adjustment layer, which controls those three things that we just talked about a moment ago, hue, saturation, and brightness. And I can edit this hue and saturation adjustment layer to change the color of the shirt. I can simply click and drag the hue slider left or right to change the hue. I can also adjust the saturation and lightness of this color. So once you make your adjustments, you may need to come back and edit your mask. So I'm going to zoom in and notice how the mask was not perfect. I can click on the layer mask and then paint with the brush tool using white to reveal the effect, or paint with black to conceal the effect. And I'm not going to spend a whole bunch of time fine-tuning the selection because it's not really important to the tutorial, but just realize that in your images, you will need to fine-tune the selections. I'm going to double click on the hand tool to see the entire image. Now I'm going to show you another way in which you can change the color, and that is by either creating a solid color adjustment layer, blue is okay for this example, or create a new layer and paint with a brush tool. In this case, we're just going to use the solid color adjustment layer, but it would be the same thing if I were actually painting on a layer. So I'm going to apply the hue saturation adjustment layer mask to this layer just to save a little bit of time. So I'm going to hold Alt, Option on the Mac, click and drag that layer mask and drop it in there. Photoshop is going to ask me if I want to replace it. Yes, I do. And there it is. Now you can use two blending modes to change the color of something. You can use hue or color. The difference is that the hue blending mode only changes the hue of the image, not the luminance and not the saturation. Color changes both the hue and saturation. In most cases, I prefer to use color because you can always come in here and adjust the saturation if need be by dragging left or right. And then, of course, you can change the color if you want to, and you can press OK. Now, how do we make a white or black shirt? To do so, you can simply create a hue and saturation adjustment layer and reduce the saturation. And we want to apply the same layer mask, but we're actually going to do something else. We're actually going to create a group and apply the layer mask onto that group. And then I can put the hue and saturation adjustment layer in there. And we're going to apply the layer mask into the group so that one layer mask can control the different adjustment layers that are going to be in there, because to get a realistic white or black shirt effect, we're going to need more than one adjustment layer. So we have this group that contains a hue and saturation adjustment layer, and I'm just going to delete that layer mask so that you can see that we're really not using it. So I brought the saturation all the way down. Then I can create a levels adjustment layer. And once again, we don't need that layer mask. You don't need to delete the layer mask, but I'm doing it so that it's clear that the group layer mask is controlling the visibility of all the layers. So we have this levels adjustment layer, and we can then control the black and white points. If I click and drag the black point to the right, I can make a black shirt and then drag this center point to control the contrast of the shirt. Or I can click and drag the white point to the left and then control the center point to adjust the contrast of the white shirt. Now you will have to do some fine tuning on the mask, but that is very simple. All you need to do is go into the group layer mask, select it, make sure that the focus, the white outline, is around the layer mask thumbnail, and then paint with white to reveal that effect. And again, I'm not going to spend time fine-tuning the layer mask, but you get the idea. I'm going to double-click on the hand tool, and this is how the white shirt looks. What I'm going to do now is merge down onto a single layer, so I'm going to press Ctrl-E, Command-E on the Mac just to collapse it all into one layer. So now we have a white shirt. So how do we make a white shirt into a red or blue shirt? What you need to do is use a color fill adjustment layer, and let me show you why. If you simply use the hue and saturation adjustment layer and you try to change the hue or saturation, nothing will happen. In terms of adding color, of course, the shirt can become black, but I really can't add any color. You can click on colorize and then try to fine tune it to get a color, but I think that it's easier to use a color fill adjustment layer. So it's up to you what you use, but just so you can see a different technique, we have this color fill adjustment layer, and changing the blending mode to color or hue really won't give you the result that you want. However, if we change the blending mode to multiply, we apply the color and the luminance of that layer onto the white shirt. So now we can just select a different color for the shirt. So that's another technique that you can use to color a shirt. One thing I want to mention is that if the shirt is a dark color, then you will use screen instead of multiply. Now we're going to work on a different example that will be a little more complicated, but I think that you can follow along. So I'm going to work with this file here of this woman wearing a plaid shirt. And if we wanted to change the red stripes on her plaid to a different color, it would be too difficult to simply select the quick selection tool and just select those specific reds. It would take way too long and you probably wouldn't be able to get a good selection. So a technique that I recommend using is creating the hue and saturation adjustment layer and taking advantage of the direct selection tool, which is this one here. You can click on that and then you can click on the color that you want to change and use the hue slider to change it. And then you can, of course, use saturation and lightness. Now, here's a little trick for you. I'm going to reset the adjustment layer, and I'm going to hold Control, that's Command on the Mac, and click. And notice how I'm changing the hue of that color I selected. If I just click and drag without holding any keys, I change the saturation of the color that I clicked on. Also, I want you to notice one thing. I'm going to reset the adjustment layer. Notice how the label reads master, but if I click, it selects the reds. If I click on the dropdown, you'll see that we have reds, yellows, greens, cyans, blues, and magentas. So this picker allows us to select the color, and it automatically selects it from the dropdown. And also notice the bottom part of the properties panel. We have these two points that tell us that the color that we selected is in between there, and that those colors will be changed when we adjust any one of these sliders. And then we have the two endpoints, which simply means that between the endpoint and this center point, we're gonna have a gradual transition of color. So it won't be a complete transition. So that's what that means here. So notice that if I select her lips, it'll select reds. And obviously clicking on here, it also selects reds. And by the way, we can adjust these, and I'll show you how in a moment. I'm gonna click on the red part of the plaid shirt while holding Control, Command on the Mac, and then drag to change this to blue. Then I'm going to zoom in, and you'll see that we didn't quite select all the colors, but we can click and drag these points to add to the selection. So now we selected more of those colors. I'm gonna fit the image to screen so we can see it all. And obviously the final step is just to isolate that adjustment to the shirt. I'm not gonna spend much time making the selection. It's the same step that we did before. You can use the quick selection tool like we did in the previous example. But in this case, I wanna save a little bit of time. So we're gonna use a pre-made selection that I made off camera. So I'm going to load that selection by holding Control, Command on the Mac, and just applying it to that adjustment layer. So there it is. And you can, of course, always come back and make adjustments to that color if need be. One thing that I want to point out is that if you hover over this icon, you can see the keyboard shortcuts. Click and drag to modify saturation, and Control click to modify hue. That's Command on the Mac. In the next example, I'm going to show you how you can target a specific color, make it into a selection, and then change its color in case you need a layer mask to contain that color. So I know it sounds a little confusing, but let me show you what I mean. We're going to work with this document, and if we wanted to change the color of this bag here in the back, but nothing else, then using the quick selection tool for that job wouldn't give us the best result. There is a lot of detail that we want to preserve. So one of the best things that you can do is use the color itself to make the selection. And you can do so by going into Select, Color Range. And if you select Image, you will see the image itself in the preview window. Or you can click on Selection. Then you can just click on the color that you want to select and click on this eyedropper with the plus sign to add colors to that selection. But as you notice, it's selecting different areas of the image, and I don't want that. I only want to select this bag. So I'm going to cancel, and I'm going to simply freehand a selection using the lasso tool. So I'm going to click around that light and just hover over the areas that contain the color that I want to select. So I'm predefining a selection. Then I'm going to go back into Select, Color Range. Now notice the preview. It only contains that area. And don't worry, the light won't be selected. So at this point, I can just set my target color, move over into the selection view, and then just add to my selection. So I'm clicking and dragging to add all those oranges to my selection. You can adjust the fuzziness slider, which expands or contracts the selection, and then press OK. And notice how Photoshop only selected the oranges of this bag. Then I can create a group and apply a layer mask based on that selection. Then I can create adjustment layers inside of that group. So hue and saturation is inside of that group. So if I move the hue slider, I will change the color only of that bag. And this becomes really useful now because we can start loading adjustment layers inside of that group, and it will only affect the areas that we selected. So we can even apply a texture, for example. So I can go into the pattern fill, select this pattern, press OK, change the blending mode to soft light and maybe reduce the opacity. So now that bag has a different color and a pattern. And of course, I can adjust the color of that bag if need be. For the next example, I'm going to show you how to change the color of objects that are difficult to select. So we're going to use this image of this tree. And what we're going to do is try to change the leaves to a different color. So maybe you want to give this tree red leaves because you're working on some sort of alien planet composite or something like that. But the point is that we want to select the leaves. So how do you select them? I'm going to show you a really cool trick using Blend Diff that I'm really sure you're going to like. So I'm going to start by duplicating the layer. Then I'm going to hide the bottom layer. And I'm going to double click to the side of the layer to bring up the layer style dialog. And I'm going to use the Blend Diff sliders. Now, if you don't know what Blend Diff is, don't worry. I have an 8-minute crash course here on YouTube that you can watch for free. I'll post the link to it down below in the description. But basically, these sliders allow you to hide pixels based on their luminosity. So notice that if I drag the black point to the right, I hide the dark pixels. If I drag the white point to the left, I hide the bright pixels. Also, if I hold down the Alt or Option key, you will notice how the point splits and I can create a smooth transition. So that is basically how it works. I also have different channels. So I can go into the blue channel, for example, and I can take out the blue in this image, in this case, the sky. So I'm building the selection with these sliders. I'm also going to hold Alt, Option, and the Mac and split those in half and create a smoother transition. Then press OK. Unfortunately, these are not transparent pixels. If I hold Control, Command, and the Mac and click to load the active pixels, it's going to load the entire layer. Because I'm only hiding those pixels based on their luminance values. But I can actually convert this into transparency by right-clicking on the layer and selecting Convert to Smart Object. Look at the layer thumbnail now. Do you see the transparency? I can hold Control, Command on the Mac, and click on that layer thumbnail once again, and this time, Photoshop actually loads transparency as a selection. So I can hide this layer, come back to my tree layer, and create a hue and saturation adjustment layer, and Photoshop automatically applies that selection as a layer mask. By the way, I'm curious to know if you knew that Blend Diff trick or not. Let me know in the comments. But anyway, you can use the hue slider to control the colors of the selected areas and use the rectangular marquee tool while holding shift to add to the selection. Holding shift adds to the selection and holding alt subtracts from the selection. So remember, shift and alt, add and subtract. So I'm adding to the selection in areas that I don't want to apply the effect to. With the selection active, I can come into the layer mask thumbnail. Make sure that you see the focus, the white outline around the layer mask, and fill with black. Black is currently my background color, so I can hold Control, Backspace, Command, Delete on the Mac to fill with black to hide the effect of that adjustment layer. Now, I want to remove the effect from the branches and the bark of the tree. So what I can do is duplicate my tree layer, Control J, Command J on the Mac, drag it on top of the hue and saturation adjustment layer, and then we can use a technique that we used in the previous example to select only brown from the image. So I'm going to go into Select, Color Range. You can then click on Image to make sure that you are able to see the tree and click to select that point. And you can also click and drag to add to that selection. If you go into the selection view, you will see that we selected pretty much all the branches and all the parts that we want to keep. Then press OK and click on the layer mask icon to create a layer mask that targets only the brown parts of the tree. In the hue and saturation adjustment layer, it's only controlling the colors of the leaves. The point of this example is for you to realize that you can stack multiple layers on top of each other and multiple adjustment layers to get the results that you need. You're not stuck just with one layer and one adjustment layer. You can do as many things as you want. Everything looks pretty good and you can go in there and fine tune the mask if you need to. Let me know in the comments which of these techniques were new to you. Also, if this is your first time at the Photoshop training channel, Don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again in the next tutorial.